You know what time it is. Top of the morning, everybody. It's Friday. Treadmill motivation time. This is how we roll. I hope you're ready. Give me a few minutes. We'll get started right after this. Good morning, Patricia. We're getting ready to get started. Hope you got your work clothes on. If you're walking outside, hope you got a dome cover on. Hope you got some comfortable tennis shoes. And please, have your H2O. You definitely want to hydrate while you're working out. We're getting ready to get started. We're going to finish up what we've been talking about. I need some discipline. I don't know about you, but I need some discipline. What's up, Janet? We're getting ready to get started. We're getting ready to rock and roll up in here. Get this thing moving. It's Friday. Man, you made it through the week. You got through all that stress. Yeah, there it is. Oh, is that a tear? Why are you crying? Or is that a happy face? Look like a tear. Be happy. God has blessed you. God is blessing you. You have a lot to rejoice about. Even though it was a sad week, we can still rejoice that God is still on the throne. We're getting ready to do this thing in a big way. But I wanted to bring it in my style. Because I'm a bass player, so, and a musician. So this is how we roll. All right, I think that's enough of that before people start shutting me down. But I just wanted to give you a little flavor because it's Friday. You need some discipline? Oh yeah, you about to get some real good discipline today. All right, look, this is what we've been talking about for this week. I started Wednesday and we're talking about 8 ways to create the discipline habit. 8 ways to discipline habit. To create discipline habit. Now, excuse me, on Wednesday, we talked about make the commitment. And then we talked about staying focused. And number 3 was prioritize your tasks. And then number 4 we left off with get sufficient rest, because it's important for you to get sufficient rest in order for you to function properly throughout the day. I appreciate you guys being here today. Thank you for joining in on this Friday's edition of Treadmill Motivation. And I pray that God continues to bless you and your family. He continues to enrich your lives, that as you seek for more of Him, that He will continue to be more present in your life. And I pray that whatever your dreams and your hopes and your aspirations are, that you first seek God, put it in God's hand, and allow God to work the plan out for you. Because in the end, it's God that's going to bring it to fruition. But you got to trust Him, you got to rely on Him. This is your boy Eminem, and this is Friday. This is the version of Treadmill Motivation, where we come together, we fellowship, I share some good nuggets with you while we're working out together. However you work out, if you walk on the treadmill like me, or if you're walking outside, walk around the room. If you're at work, walk around the office. If you have a closed office, get up and do some stretches. You know, as long as you're moving and you're active and your heart rate is above a certain level, you know, you can burn a few calories, but if you're just sitting at your desk for 8 hours, you don't move until, you know, lunchtime, you're actually cutting off your lifespan. And that's proven that those that sit at a computer all day, every day, they don't get any kind of exercise, they don't get any kind of blood flow or any kind of circulation, they're actually shortening their lifespan. So we don't want you to shorten your lifespan. We want you to hang around here a very long time. So today, what we're going to talk about today in 8 ways to create disciplined habits. Hey, Giovanni, what's up, Gio? Man, Gio, you knocked it out last night, brother. I appreciate you coming on the show. Giovanni DeReese was on our show last night. This is a hot brother from New York. And I'm going to tell you, you guys need to look him up, follow him, Giovanni DeReese. He's a good brother. Hey, Pastor Sid, how you doing, man? Appreciate you being on. I hope you got some work clothes on, or some workout clothes, some tennis shoes on, because this is treadmill motivation. This is what we do Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, even though I work out 6 days a week. I try to come in, give a little bit of what God has given me to share with those that are present and sharing their day with me as they start. As we start the day, we finish the day. Amen. All right. So, now the second half of I Need Some Discipline. This is 8 creative ways or 8 ways to create disciplined habits. Now, I always say in most of my motivation talks here that it's first natural and then spiritual. You know, that's the way we do things. There's a balance in life. You know, we get the natural part of our lives together. We definitely got to get the spiritual part of our lives in order and for us to be on key with whatever work that we want to do in life that God has blessed us with. We definitely want to be first natural and then spiritual. All right, number 5. And these are some good keys and some good elements that I use for myself, and I'm trying to be more efficient in this. Number 5, and if you missed the other 4, hey Darla, what's up? Go back and follow me on Twitter, and follow me on, which is Life's Word Men, M-I-N, Life's Word Men, on Twitter, Instagram, Life's Word Ministry, on Facebook, of course you know, it's Life's Word Ministry, or here on my personal page for M&M, or you can actually, on YouTube, man, I would really love for you guys to follow me, you know, follow these on YouTube, the videos, and share them with your friends. I always say, share them with your friends, share them with your loved ones, and share them with the people that you don't like, because we want to get into the habit of sharing good information for people that are negative in our lives. You know, so if it helps you, if it blesses you, pay it forward. Share it. Even share it now. Share it on your Facebook wall. You know that M&M is on, and this is Treadmill Motivation. It's time to get busy. I'm already sweating. Oh, you better catch up. But I appreciate you guys subscribing to my channel on Life's Word Ministry, me and Christine, on YouTube. All right, get back to business. Like I said, I hope you guys are hydrating. It's very important to hydrate while you're working out. All right, I appreciate you guys being with me today. Number 5 is eat for energy. Eat for energy. That's important because, as I stated Wednesday, good nutrition equals a smarter brain and better activity when you have food and nutrients in your body. What did they say? They say breakfast is the first meal of the day, or the something they say about breakfast is you got to have breakfast in the morning, you know, because it's important to have breakfast in the morning because it gives you energy throughout the day. So start your day with a breakfast that's high in protein and low in carbs. I know some of y'all like to eat country style. You see, I was raised up country. You know, even though I was born in the city, every summer we would go back to the country where my family was from. And you know, back in the country, they don't be playing. You know, they breakfast look like dinner. And then right after breakfast, they have lunch. And I'm like, well, didn't we just eat? Yeah, there it is, the most important meal of the day. Thank you, Pastor said. Yeah, that's what they say, breakfast. And then it's like right after we have lunch, they have what you call a supper. And I'm like, well, we just had breakfast and lunch, and now we have a supper? And then if that don't beat all, my grandmother would come out and say she's about to cook for dinner. And I'm like, good Lord, no wonder the people in the country are kind of large, because you're eating full meals a day. I mean, it's important to eat small meals per day if you're working out, because what that does, that boosts your metabolism. You know, get you some carrots and some almonds or something like that. You know, but here, you don't eat a full-blown meal, you know, four times a day. Man, but to avoid a food coma, you don't want to get into a food coma. Hey, Lou, how you doing? You don't want to get into a food coma. At lunchtime, avoid eating starchy carbs and drinking alcohol during the day. You know, if you're at work, you shouldn't be drinking anyway, because, you know, you're getting all these starchy carbs in you, and what that does, that produces a lot of sugar in your body, and you don't want that. So eat foods that are clean and alive. You know, what are those? Those eat greens, you know, like, I ain't talking about good old country greens, but if you like good old country greens like I do, well, eat you some greens. But any green leafy substance, food, it's important for your carbs, and it's important to have a lean meat for your protein. Now, if you don't eat meat, you're gonna have to find a supplement to supplement that meat, that iron that you need, and that protein that you're missing in the meat. That's why I don't understand how people can be, right, no food coma. You don't wanna be no food coma. I don't understand people say that they're vegetarians, and they're missing one of the most important supplements of food is meat. Yeah, you don't like meat, you don't wanna kill no animals, you know, but go back to creation, you know, when the fall of man. That's when it all started. You got to eat in order to survive. You know, even though they were considered, I guess, you know, it's not really proven. Well, yeah, I guess you can, if you deep in the Bible, like, you know, I got that master's, and we talked about far as, well, was Adam and Eve vegetarians? Because the Bible doesn't really say if they're vegetarians or if they ate meat. It just said that they tended to the garden. Well, there was a lot of things in the garden, and they had a lot of vegetables and fruits in the garden, right? Yeah. So we really don't know. It's just this, we have to trust and believe, whatever we trust and believe, that their needs were met. However, because God allowed us to have meat by way of certain animals, okay, it was for our bodies and the nutrition that we need from certain meats, okay? All right, so that's enough with that. Now, but you wanna make sure to drink throughout the day a significant amount of water. That's most important. You know, like I say, this is all talking about 8 ways to create discipline habit. Okay, I know y'all thought I was getting ready to get on here and preach. No, that's later. But we get ready to drop it down, drop it like it's hot, when we talk about the spiritual side of motivation and spiritual side of discipline. That's when we really get hot. But right now, we're talking about the natural side of us. That's right. Truth speaking, my belly is saying amen. Why are you abusing me? I'm not trying to abuse you. I'm just trying to share and help you with eating right, getting the right supplements in your body. Hey, Cheryl. And making sure that it's balanced. Yeah, I ain't telling you to stop eating. Go on and eat, but eat in moderation. Because like I said, you don't want to be in a food coma throughout the day. You know, you eat so much during the day, you know, and if you don't eat dinner at night, the next day you're like a raging lion. You're about ready to bite somebody. But you want to, in moderation, eat throughout the day so your body can handle going at certain lengths of time without food, all right? Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. All right, look, you need to stay away from simple sugars, because too much caffeine and nicotine is not good for you. Now, granted, I'm not harping and getting on anybody's case about drinking coffee. I love coffee, because when I'm done working out through this motivation time, I take my shower. Hey, Phillips, how you doing? Talisa, I get me some coffee, and then I get to my job. I get to my business, you know? But I work, I don't eat. That's biblical. So it's important that you drink plenty of water, stay away from the simple sugars, and too much caffeine and too much caffeine and too much caffeine and too much caffeine. See, that's what caffeine does for you. It just gets you all amped up. And if you're a smoker, you really need to cut back. Because what you're doing, you're cutting off your life, one, cutting off your lifespan, and you're cutting off your oxygen supply by filling your lungs with foreign matter. Now, I can say that now, but back in the day, you know, when I didn't know any better, and yes, I was out smoking weed and getting high and all the things that we did as a young man, you know, but God delivered me. Now, I'm thankful that, you know, I didn't abuse my body in such a way. Hey, Tony, what's up? Abuse my body in such a way that I look older than I am. I'm 57. 5'7". I know it's hard to believe. I know it. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Throw me some hands up. Throw me some thumbs up or something. Agree with me. Say amen. You know, right? My goodness. Y'all just blank. What happened to my hearts and my thumbs up this morning? All right. Let's go on. Now, by avoiding, there you go. Thank you. By avoiding some of these detrimental things to your body, this will help you keep your energy flowing throughout the day. And that's the most important aspect of working, is making sure that, hey, I'm still the baby, 57, 5'7". but you wanna make sure that your flow is in its energy level is high. Make sure to pick little snacks or pack little snacks that you can have throughout the day. And like I said earlier, such as protein bars and almonds. Those are a great source of getting the protein and energy that you need during the day. I know you are some professional snackers. I know you are. I'm a professional snacker. You know, we go to the grocery store. Before we go to the vegetable aisle, we go to the snack aisle. That's funny, but it's truth. You know, you are what you eat. And I'm trying to help us be a better us in developing creative ways of developing better disciplined habits, because I need to be disciplined. I need some disciplining. All right. So throughout the day, your energy level will stay up if you have snacks that are high in protein, like almonds. That's important, almonds, and maybe protein bars. And I know some protein bars taste like grass and taste like cardboard. Sample the protein bars that you like and stick with that and keep that in your car. Keep it at your work, in your desk or something, somewhere close, that when you start getting those hungry monsters, you can calm that hungry monster down with a protein bar. All right, now make sure that when you pack your lunches or pack your snacks, that you have well-balanced diet within those snacks, because as well as to maintain blood sugar levels, that's important. What's up, Darla? Dayla? Darla? Can't see that. Done. I'll just say done. I don't have my glasses on. Forgive me, y'all. But you want to lower your blood sugar levels, and that's a perfect way of lowering your blood sugar levels. And what are we talking about today? We're talking about number 5, eat for energy. You want to eat for energy. A lot of people eat for sport. They eat for play. They just eat just to eat. I'm not downing that. I'm not criticizing that. I love to eat. But you want to eat for energy. Eat foods that's going to give you energy. Now, most of you on here will understand this next phrase. Many of us, after we eat, we have the itis. We all know what the itis is. What's the itis? I'm not going to go there right now, but those of you that know, what's up, Earl? Good to see you, brother. But those of you that know what itis is, you know. You know, as soon as you eat, everybody is guilty of this. Not just one particular race, but everybody. If you eat to a certain level, one, you're going to go into a food coma, and you're going to go to sleep. That's just a given. It's not just turkey. People say, oh, I eat a lot of turkey, I go to sleep. No, it's food, period. All right. Number six is do the little things. Oh, how important is that, to do the little things in life? A great way to cultivate the habit of being disciplined is to focus on doing the little things you know you should do, okay? Things that you know you should do, such as making your bed. Sound like your mom and your dad, huh? And you thought this was about disciplined habits as far as living a great life. Stay with me. Don't lose out on me now. Don't blank out on me now. Don't leave now. Stay in the pulpit. Stay in the congregation with me for a minute. Because I'm going to share with you how important this is. This is something that I taught my children when they were growing up. You know, hey Sandra, when I was growing up, me and my brother, it was like Oscar and Felix. You guys remember the show Oscar and Felix, the odd couple? Well, we were definitely the odd couple. My brother was more messier than me, you know, and when we used to share a room, you know, I try to keep my side of the room clean. His room was, side of the room was always dirty. I was like thankful when, you know, we finally got our own rooms because now I can prove to my mom that it wasn't my mess. It was my brother's mess. But this is something that I taught my children that, you know, when you make your bed in the morning, it sets a certain precedence for the day. Because what you're doing before you leave the house, your area is straightened, your area is clean, your area, as they say in the military, is policed. And this is why I entreat, you know, young men that are young women that are growing up, you know, to join some type of armed service because it teaches them, what are we talking about today? Discipline. It teaches them discipline and how to discipline their lives. And as simple and simplistic as this sounds, making your bed is very important, especially as an entrepreneur. I guess you say how? Especially as a business owner, I guess you say how? Well, I'm getting ready to tell you how. Because when you become more disciplined in cleaning your room, cleaning your house, and cleaning your bed, or straightening your bed before, people say, well, I'm gonna get back in it anyway, why should I make it up? It's a certain mindset. Because if you straighten up, clean up, the rest of your day will be straightened up and cleaned up. It's a mindset. And you're keeping your environment clean. That's important. And when you keep your environment clean, everything follows with you. And like I said, this is something I was teaching my children. They didn't understand why they had to make their bed in the morning. They didn't understand why they had to keep their room clean. I said, because when you really think about it, as your room goes, your life goes throughout the day. If your room is nasty, if your room is messy, if your bed is unmade, guess what that's gonna do? That's gonna carry over into your car. Uh-oh, your car is nasty. Your car is not clean. So you see how it follows you? And then what happens is because your bedroom and your house is not clean, I know it sounds like I'm preaching to y'all, but I'm talking to me too, but people that know me, they know I'm an avid cleaner, my kids especially. And what happens now is because the mess in your house has now moved to your car. And because your car isn't stationary, unless it's a bucket, you now take all that mess to your job. And so now your desk is a mess. I did say mess. Your desk is a mess because you now brought the atmosphere and the environment from your home to your job. And consequently, what's gonna happen if you're like that now and you don't change now, if you're not married, that's gonna carry over into your marriage. That's not good either. Nobody wants to be your housekeeper. Nobody wants to clean up after some grown person. Clean up after yourself, pick up after yourself. You know, this is why you teach your children, you know, things. Here, let me share something with you on a side note. When people start quoting the scripture, train up a child in the way they should go, y'all need to stop quoting that when it's time to discipline children. Y'all need to stop that. I was guilty of that too because we learn what we're taught until we learn better and then we can teach better. So with that, here's what you need to do. Yes, we train up a child in the way that he or she goes, and when they are old, they will not depart from it, right? However, you need to teach them not only that scripture in disciplining, but you need to teach them in reference of entrepreneurship. Teach them in a way of bettering themselves. Teach them in a way that is positive and not negative. Train up a child. How do you want your child to grow? How do you want them to be when they get your age? You want them to be well-disciplined in every area of their lives. You want them to be well-educated. You want them to be very motivated, right? You don't want them to grow up to be thugs. Dirt in, dirt out. So this is how we can change and create creative discipline habits. Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he's old, he will not depart from it. She will not depart from it. That's discipline habit right there. Because now you probably need to go back and retrain yourself on that scripture and say, okay, I need to clean my house. I need to clean my room. It's like this. Whenever I go on vacation, right? You go on vacation, you have a good time, you come back. What's the first thing you do? Throw your suitcase on the bed or on a chair, and it stays there for weeks. When I come home, now, this is not a slight on anybody. This is just me. This is practical application, okay? When I come home, the first thing I do before I sit down and say, "Ooh, I'm so glad to be home," I unpack everything. I put what needs to be washed in the dirty clothes hamper. I put up whatever's that hasn't been worn. I put it in my drawer and I hang it up. Now I'm free for the rest of the day. I don't have to come back in the room and look at that packed suitcase anymore. Some of us are packing stuff in a suitcase in our lives and it's just hanging around. You need to unpack some of that mess in that suitcase so you can have a free life and so you can have a free day and a free moment. Woo! Hey, we're talking about do the little things. That's part of the little things. Listen, when you keep your car clean, you keep your environment clean. Take the garbage out. Pick up after yourself. These are the little things. People say, "I don't like taking out the trash." Well, who you think gonna take it out? Especially if you live alone. You got children? This is what I used to think that I was for when I was growing up. Take out the trash. You know, I'd be in the room chilling. My parents say, "Hey," you call me Tony back in the day. "Tony, come here." You know, I go run, see what's up, take the trash out. I'm like, what? I had to come all the way from my room so I could take the trash out? But I knew better to talk back. I knew better to debate. You don't be debating. What's wrong with you guys allowing your children to debate with you today? Are you serious? Who's the parent in the house? You know, I hear kids debating with their parents and stuff, talking back, and the parents just look at them like, ooh, and like, are you serious? Man, we need to go back to the old school. Let them know what it was like when we was growing up. You know, let them, hey, these are the little things. This is developing a disciplined habit for your life. It's Friday, so I'm wound up today. So, here's another important thing is, when you take the garbage out and you pick up after yourself, you're setting an atmosphere of not settling for mess. You're not settling for mess. So now when you're in the office and your office desk is array, you straighten it before you leave. So when you come back the next morning, you have a clean environment to work in. And so now your creative juices are flowing because there's no mess on the desk. Oh, I like that one. No mess on the desk. All right. The other thing, as you discipline yourself to do the little things, you will become more disciplined in doing the bigger things and more important things. But you got to start somewhere. It's like when I tell you about these treadmill motivations. You know, I had to start off small. I had to start off, you know, taking my time. You know, I couldn't just get on this treadmill and throw it on 9 and expect not to pass out, you know? I had to start this thing off on 1 and then work my way up. It's the little things over time. And once it's compounded, the compounding effect is tremendous. It's like the compounding effect in investment. You know, I'm not gonna talk about that, that's a whole different show. But if you invest a little of your time every day, the outcome is so much greater, all right? Number 7. Follow through. This is important. Make decisions ahead of time. If you decide to exercise, like I decide to exercise each morning before work, then don't allow yourself to talk yourself out of working out before you go to work, because it's easy to do that. You might stay up a little later than normal. Then all of a sudden now, when 6 o'clock comes around, your body is like, "Oh, I ain't trying to get up. I need some sleep. So what you need to do now Not that this is what you need to do. I don't want to get into a habit of telling people what they need to do, but as a suggestion, right? As a suggestion is start off small. You know, you want to exercise. Make the mindset the night before. This is your mindset. I'm going to get up in the morning at whatever time you set. Set your clock. Do not hit that snooze button. You need to get rid of that snooze button because that snooze button is the devil. You know, people have missed a lot of appointments because of that little snooze button. We don't need no snooze button. If the clock goes off, we need to get up. It's just that simple. Get rid of that snooze button. Put some tape over it or something. But if you're going to take on any important endeavors or projects in the morning, don't second guess decisions in the morning. If you made a decision the night before, you've mapped it out, you planned it out, you strategize, and then the morning comes, now all of a sudden you have buyer's remorse, as they say, or I call thinker's remorse, because now you slept on it, and now you're second guessing what you've decided to do from last night. You have 10 toes and you are stepping. I'm sorry. Well, you have to soak your feet after this. I'll pray for you before I'm done. How about that? All right. This is not easy for myself, y'all, because in order for me to share from my heart, I had to first deal with it myself. And as I go down in prayer each morning, I have a prayer room. I have a war room. I go down and I pray. And many of you know that on my wall, I have post-its stuck on my wall, all over my wall of different things and different ones that I'm praying for and asking God to touch, deliver, and heal and manifest himself in their lives, you know, bless them in a special way. Because it's not about me. It's about how I can pray for others and bless others. I had to learn that. I just wake up saying it's about y'all because it was always about me. And some things it should be about you because this is your life and you want your life to be happy. So in that aspect, yeah, it is about you and your happiness. But have it in retrospect of being positive while you're in front of people. All right, follow through is number 7. So the decision is made. After you made the decision the night before, you wake up in the morning, think about it, you see what you've written down. The decision was made last night, stick with it. Stick with the decisions that you made last night. My mother said, you know, not too long ago, she said, if you make a decision and you're happy with that decision, why are you second guessing the decision? Have faith and trust in that decision. Now that sounds really great when it's in retrospect to what we want in life, right? But if it's not according to what we want, we don't want to quote that. You know, we want to tell people, oh, you don't need to do that. Why are you doing that? I wouldn't do that. Well, you're not me. You're not them. You know, you're your own person. So if you make a decision and if you feel right within yourself and you've consulted the Lord on this decision, and it's, if it's a big business deal, business transaction, or meeting, a test, whatever it is, if you've gone to God and you've sought God and God has given you the AAA seal, he's anointed it, he's appointed it, and then he approved it. That's the AAA seal. Then go from there and know that the decision you made was the right decision. Sometimes the decision we make might not be the right decision. You won't learn that until after the fact. Then we go back and we reevaluate, okay, what decision, what was the determining factor in that decision? Was it for my benefit? Was it for other people's benefit? We have to reevaluate some of the decisions we make because some decisions might be strictly selfish and we don't want to be that. Commercial time. I ain't trying to listen to these commercials. Now, listen. So follow through with the decisions you made last night. Now, without follow through, you have no discipline, right? That's important. If you don't follow through, there is no discipline there. So one important area of discipline is following through. Follow through with it. I tell you in basketball, you know, if you got a jumper from 20 feet out, follow through. Because you don't know if that ball is going to hit the iron and bounce off. You want to be able to follow through. Follow your shot so you can be able to rebound the shot so other people can't take what God has blessed you with. So follow through. Follow through. You have no discipline, as I said. Your mind is often your greatest enemy when it comes to following through. I like how Les Brown said that African proverb is, if there's no enemy within, the enemy outside can do us no harm. So if there's no enemy within, the enemy in me, enemy is in me, we have to kill that enemy, the enemy that brings division, the enemy that brings discord, that enemy that brings gossip, that enemy that brings negative energy. All these things, we have to dismiss it. That's an enemy. And we don't need those type of enemies in our lives. This is why we go to warfare every day of our lives. We fight off these enemies. And sometimes, sad to say, your family is your biggest enemy. I'm gonna leave that alone. Some of y'all family, you need to pray for. You know you do. So you must win this battle and keep up on all you have planned to do. Don't fall back on your plans. Don't fall back on them. If you plan to do something, stick to it, follow through, and make sure you get through it. Now, the last one, number 8. I'm glad you guys are hanging with me. And if you have to leave, you can always come back and watch the replay on YouTube or on Facebook. But I really appreciate you guys hanging with me today, because it's Friday. You know, I'm just giving you the rest of what I have today so we can start something fresh on Monday. Now, number 8. If you don't remember anything, remember this. Reward yourself. That is so vital today. Reward yourself. I've seen couples, and this is kind of sad to say, couples will treat someone outside of their relationship better than they treat their own mates. I've been there. I've done that. I got the t-shirt and the hat, and I was selling tickets, but not any longer. God delivered me from that. And that's the thing. When God delivers you from something, you know you've been delivered. People outside don't know you've been delivered until they see the active lifestyle of a person that's been changed. Other than that, when they see you, you're still the same old you to them. That's why they treat you the way they treat you. When you have goals, you want to start a new job project, you want to get married, you want to move, whatever it is. If your family is accustomed of you being wishy-washy and they're accustomed to you being flaky, well, the only way that their mind and thoughts of you about that is going to change is by a constant lifestyle, active move. Ooh, I'm getting tired. You got to consistently be positive. You got to consistently show them that God has changed you, because they're going on the past of how you used to be. So, in order for them to have a new thought of you, teach them a new thought of you. How do you teach them? By living it in front of them, all right? I need to hydrate, y'all. I need to hydrate. We're wrapping it up. Coming down to the last. All right. Like I say, I appreciate you guys hanging with me. I hope that you share this with your friends, share with your loved ones, and share with those you don't really like. All right? Follow me on Twitter. Follow me on Facebook. Follow me on Instagram. Follow me on YouTube. Life's Word Ministry. And life is hyphen with an S. It's apostrophe S. It's Life's Word Ministry. And subscribe to my YouTube, and you'll be able to follow all the videos that I've made. All right. Number 8, and we're finishing, is reward yourself. You can tell I'm winding down, I'm tired. Reward yourself. When you see the success you have created exploding right in front of your eyes, you need to reward yourself. If you like, say, you're walking with me on this treadmill and you finish a program, man, bully, I praise you for that. Great job, awesome. Now reward yourself. Don't reward yourself with no ice cream now, but reward yourself. You know, tell yourself, that was a great job. I did good today. Follow through on the motivation treadmill motivation today. Man, this is getting good because now every day I feel myself getting stronger. So reward yourself after you've completed a certain task. Be happy and proud of yourself. Share with your loved ones what you have achieved, and take everyone out to dinner. That might be a little bit, right? But if you want to reward yourself, say you lost 5 pounds, rejoice. Take everybody out to eat. You have a salad. And just rejoice that you've met a certain goal. You've reached a level. Hey, Gail, how you doing? Gail, how you doing? You've reached a certain level now that you can achieve, and you share with your family and friends. Sometimes it's hard to share great accomplishments with family and friends. I understand that. However, be consistent in sharing not only the good, but you know, they've already seen you live the negative. So you really don't have to broadcast that because they already broadcasting it for you. But change how you teach them how to treat you. Reward yourself. Be proud of what you've done and accomplished. Now, you need to get to a level to where you can enjoy your life, go out and celebrate. Have a few drinks or whatever it is, and celebrate your hard work and subsequent achievements, because you've reached a certain level in your life that now that you're happy because, you know, you started a new job, you started a new business venture. People looking at you like, what? What you selling now? You selling travel? Is that a pyramid? They used to always give me. I was like, wait, time out. Pyramid, travel, travel, pyramid. How in the world is that a pyramid scheme? Really? I really don't think people think of some of the comments that they make. It just sounds good rattling around in a little peanut skull, and then they want to spew it all over you. Only pyramid in my travel business are the pyramids over in Egypt. Yeah. Anyway, but you want to, hey Karen, what's up? You want to be able to reward yourself of the accomplishments you made. Share it with people and be consistent with sharing it with people. Feel good about what you're doing. Feel good about what you accomplished. Each time you witness your own success, what you're doing, you see your discipline habit paying off. It is this payoff which motivates you to stay disciplined. Man, I love that. You know, I say it again. Each time you witness your success, what you're doing, you see discipline habit paying off. And it is this payoff which motivates you to be disciplined. We had a young brother on the show last night. Like I said, Giovanni DeReese. He said something that was profound. It was kind of funny. He said, if you look at the word success, you know, if you spell out the word success, S-U-C-C-E-S-S, well, before you get to success, you got to go through, you have to suck. S-U-C. You got to suck before you get to the cess. So in order to be successful, sometimes you're going to suck. And there's been plenty of times that I sucked trying to be successful, right? Man, it's like, what'd you say? She said, someone to criticize your growth because they are stuck in their own non-growth. That's right. People, they will criticize you because you decide that you want to be better, do better, and have better. And it's like their mindset is, well, oh, I guess you all that now. I guess you just Mr. and Mrs. Expert now. No, but I'm working to my perfection. Practice, as the young brother said last night, is everything. I say practice is purposeful, and it also makes room for improvement. So, yes, think yourself great. Think yourself all that. Think yourself wonderful. Think yourself fabulous. Think yourself extraordinary. There's nothing wrong with that. You motivate yourself. You pick yourself up. Because when others don't, and they won't, you have to. David said in the Bible, I have to encourage myself. When his whole kingdom was discouraged, David got up there and he danced before the Lord until all his clothes fell off. Hey, Cynthia, how you doing? His clothes fell off, right? People thought he was butt naked. No, you wrong. David still had his undergarment on, but as a king, he danced out of his priestly robe. Sometimes you need to dance out of your priestly robe in front of your family. Get indignant in a spiritual way and says, you might talk about me, you might not encourage me, you might not support me, but I'm going on in the Lord. I'm going on because God has promised, he's provided my provision, and I'm moving in purpose. All right, let me finish this so I can let y'all go. Now, to stay disciplined, how do you stay disciplined? To stay disciplined, you must adapt the mindset of what the logo and the commercial adages for Nike. What does Nike say? Nike says, just do it. You gotta take that mindset. Just do it. Wake up in the morning, praise God for seeing another day. Look in the mirror and go, just do it. All right? If you're with me, type, just do it. Just do it. Come on, y'all. If you're with me, type, just do it. All right. Now, don't allow your mind to talk you out of doing what you need to do. To achieve what you have to commit, you've committed to excellence. Don't allow your mind to talk you out of what you've decided the night before. That's right, just do it. But keep a frame of mind. Attack each day with a commitment to being disciplined, healthy, maintaining good energy, and keeping your mindset motivated and positive. Attack your stress factors first. Attack your stress. That's right, just do it. Attack your stress the first thing in the morning. Whatever was stressing you out the night before, handle it the first thing in the morning so you can focus on the longer term goals and for you to remain in a positive mindset the rest of your day. When you are disciplined, you are less stressed, which turns you into a greater success. So, as I wrap this up, as I close it down for this Friday's Treadmill Motivation, I hope I've said something that's encouraged you. That's right, make that bed. That's important. I hope I pray that I've said something to encourage you this week on Eminem's Treadmill Motivation. I appreciate you guys hanging out with me. I hope that you are each day working towards a certain level of success in your life. You know, as you wake up in the morning, you know, even when you come back from work, if you're not able to work out with me, you know, in the morning because you have to go to work or a meeting or whatever, play this back on YouTube and watch it on YouTube and just be encouraged. Be encouraged. And yes, that's right. Do not allow negative people. Do not allow negative people or your own negative thoughts I can't see that, I ain't got my glasses on. To invade your positive. That's right. Thank you so much. I didn't have my glasses on. But like I said, I appreciate you guys sharing with me, allowing me to come into your home, come into your lives, these times of motivating you, Treadmill Motivation. This is your boy Eminem. As I say, go to YouTube. You can follow me on YouTube, Life's Word Ministry. That's where Christy and I have our YouTube channel. Subscribe, follow us, and share with your friends. Now, Monday, I might try something new. I might start this from Periscope. That way, if you're on Twitter, follow me on Twitter, which is Life's Word Men, Life's Word Men, M-I-N, Life's Word Men on Twitter. Follow me there so you can get this on Periscope. It'll be streamed live on Twitter and also on Facebook. But I pray that you guys have an awesome day. I pray in Jesus' name that your day be successful, that any negative energy that's surrounding you, that I bind it in the name of Jesus, that it be gone. I pray your strength. I pray good health. I pray positiveness. I pray a better day for you and your family. I love you. I appreciate you. Love God. Love yourself. And as I always say, love others. Live, hope, and change. I appreciate you. Thanks very much. Love you, Christine. Hey, y'all, we got 99 days before we get married. 99 days, the countdown. All right, you guys, I'll see you Monday, if not sooner.